What thoughts have you had in these last few days?
Well, I won't kid you to say that it's something that I feel that I am in control of, or something that I've come to terms with, because I haven't. It's a moment by moment thing. Sometimes I feel very tranquil, and other times I don't feel tranquil at all. What's going through my mind right now is to use the minutes and hours that I have left as fruitfully as possible and see what happens. It helps to live in the moment in the essence that we use it productively. So right now I'm feeling calm, and in large part because I'm here with you.
For the record, you are guilty of killing many women and girls.
Yes, that's true.
Ted, how did it happen? Take me back. What are the antecedents of the behavior that we've seen? So much grief, so much sorrow, so much pain for so many people. Where did it start? How did this moment come about?
That's the question of the hour, and one that not only people much more intelligent than I have been working on for years, but one that I've been working on for years and trying to understand it. Is there enough time to explain it all? I don't know. I think I understand it, though. Understand what happened to me, to the extent that I can see how certain feelings and ideas developed in me to the point where I began to act out on them. Certain very violent and very destructive feelings.
Let's go back then to those roots. First of all, you, as I understand it, were raised in what you consider to have been a healthy home.
Absolutely.
You were not physically abused. You were not sexually abused. You were not emotionally abused.
No, no way. And that's part of the tragedy of this whole situation, is because I grew up in a wonderful home with two dedicated and loving parents, one of five brothers and sisters. A home where we as children were the focus of my parents' lives, where we regularly attended church, two Christian parents who did not drink, they did not smoke, there was no gambling.
Hearts that pump only me, no eyes, no beak, you're eating that shit. Congratulations.
See you on. 4 years ago, in this quiet forest, in this cozy cabin, something happened. Something so frightening. Something so deadly. Something so evil. We prayed it would never happen again.
Treats are for little kids, not dogs.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are about to witness some scenes from the next attraction to play this theater. This picture, truly one of the most unusual ever filmed, contains scenes which under no circumstances should be viewed by anyone with a heart condition.
kid after you committed your first murder, what was the emotional effect on you?
What happened in the days after that?
Well, again, this, please understand that even all these years later, it's very difficult to talk about it and reliving it through talking about it. It's difficult to say the least, but I want you to understand what happened. It was like coming out of some kind of horrible trance or dream. I can only liken it to after, you know, I don't want to over-dramatize it, but to have been possessed by something.